Your favorite aunt and uncle are on their way to visit you. Great, but you haven't cleaned your place in a few days, maybe weeks, and you realize the place stinks. Thank goodness for Febreze, right? Actually, thank chemistry. We at Reactions love talking about our sense of smell. Believe it or not, scientists don't fully understand how we smell smells, but here's our chemist friend Chad Jones on what we do know.
Volatile molecules, and those are the chemicals that evaporate quickly and get into the air, travel through the air into our nose. They enter our nose and bind to receptors. Those receptors send messages to our brain about the kind of chemical that's in our nose. What we're not sure about is how those receptors work. Some say receptors work like a lock and key, with the molecule acting like a key in the lock receptor. Others have suggested that since each molecule vibrates in its own special way, the receptors can detect those vibrations.
We may not know exactly how our smell receptors work, but we do know chemical compounds are responsible for every smell out there, and there are lots of them, good and bad. We love the smell of roses, fresh-cut grass, and of course, bacon. And we hate the smell of rotten eggs, skunks, BO, and grimy bathrooms. And don't leave a comment saying, "Oh, I like rotten egg smell." You're lying. Liar. Anyway, sometimes even the amount of a chemical you have can affect how it smells. Take indoles. In small amounts, this family of compounds smell like flowers. Ah. But if you get too much indole in one place, it changes from a flowery smell to a really crappy smell. Literally. Poo emoji. So what do we do when we don't want to smell something? Opening a window to convince the foul-smelling molecules to leave is always an option, or you can try to overpower it with something more pleasant, like a candle. Or if you're in middle school or from New Jersey, Axe body spray. You may have used Febreze or some other deodorizer. Now, these products claim to neutralize the odors instead of just masking them, but what does that even mean?
Well, Febreze contains a type of chemical called a cyclodextrin. It's a cage-like molecule shaped like a funnel. This molecule traps other molecules inside the cage. So if an offending odor is present, it'll be trapped in the cage, unable to escape and get to your nose. But here's the question. If Febreze binds up odors so well, how is it possible to have a scented version of Febreze?
Whoa. Quick fun fact, the medical term for the lack of a sense of smell is called anosmia. If your minds aren't completely blown by all of that already, let us know your other burning chemistry questions in the comments. If you're really curious about smelling, we talk more about our sense of smell in our episode on roses. We also talk about your dog's sense of smell, which is way stronger than yours. Way. Like, subscribe, share, stop and smell the roses. In that order. Smell you later, chem heads.